Come on, the dollar store's making it too easy. Welcome to another episode of Quick Cuts. In this episode of The Gamesmith, we're going to be turning Easter decorations from the dollar store into coral trees.
Since it's March, the dollar store in my town has been flooded with Easter decorations. Well, to be fair, they've been putting them out since January. In any case, I immediately noticed these glitter-covered trees, and I thought, wow, that looks like coral. There are a few different colors, and I've chosen yellow and pink. I think these colorful Easter decorations are really cool, but all the glitter is going to be a problem at the game table. In addition to the coral-like appearance, these would make great fey or alien plants, but that's another video. For the coral, I want to remove this glitter so it doesn't end up all over the players or the other terrain at the table. First, we have to remove the burlap wrap, and we reveal a concrete base? Yep, this is concrete. Now we need to cut our tree free. There's a metal frame inside. Well, that certainly helps keep the tree standing up. Next, we need to wash off the glitter. I think that simple soap and water will do the trick. I'll use a brush to vigorously scrape the glitter off. Anyone who has worked with glitter before knows that it's the herpes of the crafting world. Now, I've just realized that the soap and hot water has weakened the glue on our Easter decorations. I can actually remove the branches from the trunk quite easily. Oh wow, okay. The glitter is some kind of coating, not bits of glitter glued to the branches. This coating just slides right off. Well, at least that makes this job a lot easier. After all the glitter is removed, we're left with this pristine branch. Next, I wanted to sort out our branches, only to find out that they're all the same branch. So we're gonna have to get a bit creative. Fortunately, we have enough of these branches that we can experiment with a variety of configurations in order to create different terrain pieces. Now we can turn our attention to our bases. We're going to use these 7.6 centimeter or 3 inch wood discs as our bases for our coral trees. To make sure our trees have some weight on the bottom, we'll add some heavy metal washers. These were about 15 cents each at the local hardware store. Because our trees are somewhat tall, the extra weight will prevent them from tipping over or being knocked over when players reach for their miniatures at the game table. We'll use some hot glue to attach our washers to the wood disc. Please be very careful while gluing, since the metal will conduct the heat very quickly. Of course, you don't have to use hot glue, and you can avoid this safety hazard. When it comes to creating our coral trees, we need only arrange our plastic branches on our weighted bases. Since all the branches are the same, I want to make a few cuts here and there in order to make each terrain piece look different. While we're only presenting one build here, we're actually making 6 separate trees. We could just use hot glue to attach our plastic branches to the base. We might have to hold the branches in place a moment in order to make sure they hold. If you've been watching our aquatic accessories videos, then you'll know that we've been saving our cork fragments from our other builds. All those little bits that broke off or were excess from cutting the cork into shape were kept, and now we can use them to add texture to our base. We simply add some hot glue in small areas of our base and pour the cork fragments over it. With a craft stick, we can press the cork into the hot glue until the glue cools enough so that we can use our fingers to shape our base. By repeating this process, we can cover the base and we can create this awesome texture. Just like we've done for almost all our other aquatic accessories videos, we're gonna add a thick layer of dark gray paint mixed with Mod Podge. Once our first layer is on, we'll add some decorative sand to add a bit more texture to the base. After the Mod Podge mixture is dry, we'll add a second layer to seal in the decorative sand and reinforce our cork fragments. If you end up getting some paint mixture on your coral tree, you just need a clean and wet brush in order to wash away the paint. Or if you let the mixture dry, you can easily scrape it off with a craft knife. For our final step, just like many of our other aquatic accessories, we just add a turquoise overbrush to give the base that submerged watery feel. We want to overbrush the large surface features and avoid getting any of the turquoise paint in the dark nooks and crannies. One final note, you may want to add a gloss finish to the entire build in order to give it a wet shine. I'm avoiding that because I want to be able to use this terrain piece in other environments besides the water, and I think the gloss finish looks too wet for my tastes. And here's the final view of our Easter decorations turned into coral trees. You never know where you're going to find inspiration for your terrain builds. Even Easter decorations can be turned into interesting and dynamic terrain for your game table. If you'd like to support us here at the Gamesmith, please subscribe and comment or tell a friend about the channel. You could also sign up to be a Patreon supporter, and for as little as $1 a month, you get access to exclusive content that deals with the channel and role-playing games in general. You could also check out our website at thegamesmith.org and read our blog posts, check out our supply lists, and visit our new Amazon affiliate links. By making any kind of purchase through any of these Amazon affiliate links, we get a small amount of money to help fund the channel. So even if you're not purchasing any crafting supplies, your purchases through our affiliate links will help out the channel. We also have the Gamesmith merchandise on our website. T-shirts, coffee mugs, dice bags, stickers, and more. All available in various sizes and colors. We're also on Facebook, Pinterest, and Instagram. So please check us out and share us on social media. Until next time, I'll see you at the table.